So this winter is proving to be a very severe year again for influenza, and it's different from last year. Last year was an H3N2 year, and we were seeing a lot of severe disease in the elderly. This year, we're seeing a lot of severe disease in children and young adults. We think that's because this year, the virus that's circulating is the 2009 H1N1, the same virus essentially as the one that caused the pandemic in 2009. And it's caused a lot of severe disease, children and young adults ending up in the ICU, some on heart-lung support, and there have been a number of deaths. It's a good time to remind people about the things that they need to know about flu that they may think they know. First is that influenza can be a very severe disease. We lump colds and flu together, but influenza can put you flat on your back, give you a high fever. In many cases, it can put you in the hospital. And particularly for some groups, the very young, the very old, those with heart disease, lung disease, pregnant women, people with diabetes, people with cancer, it is more likely to cause very severe disease leading to complications like pneumonia, ICU admission, and even death. The next thing you need to know is that we can do a fair bit to prevent flu. Flu vaccine is not a perfect vaccine, but it does provide pretty good protection in almost all groups. And just like a seatbelt provides pretty good but not perfect protection, you wouldn't think about driving 80 miles an hour without it. You shouldn't go without a flu vaccine, particularly if you're in one of those high-risk groups that I mentioned. It's recommended for all people. The other thing that people need to know about influenza is that treatment is available. Treatment's particularly important for people in the high-risk groups, the very young, the very old, pregnant women, and those with medical conditions. Treatment involves antiviral drugs like oseltamivir, known as Tamiflu, or zanamivir, known as Relenza. And for otherwise healthy people with uncomplicated flu, the benefits are modest. It can reduce your illness by a day or so. But if you're in the high-risk group, if you're sick enough to end up in the hospital, we have abundant data saying that these drugs actually prevent ICU admission and can reduce the chance of death. What that means is that if you think you have influenza, you should contact your physician immediately, particularly if you're in one of the high-risk groups. And if you think you have severe disease, you're having difficulty breathing, you can't keep fluids down, you need to seek medical care immediately.